So today we went to the heritage walk of Goa, made by Make It Happen. They are an amazing group who are doing heritage walks throughout Goa. They are doing a lot of stuff. We learned quite a few things about the Goan architecture that was, and how it was influenced by the Portuguese that came over here. How they actually, you know, used those old ideologies, and in ancient times how they were able to actually use the natural resources that were present within the natural surroundings of Goa to make a, you know, great habitat which survived the test of time, as well as was very practical to the use and the temperature that people lived in over here. So behind me is the Panjim Inn. This is a heritage building, and it is also part of the Welcome Heritage Group, in which they have converted some of the heritage buildings into a hotel. Over here you'll see quite a few salient features of the Goan architecture. So one of them being the slight arched out balconies, and them having a support on the bottom, like this one. Now people do it in various other structures. They use quite different designs, very European style designs are used over here to support this kind of an outward protrusion of a balcony. In the ancient times it was actually used in a way so that the man of the house could actually come onto the porch and smoke for some good time ahead, so that the smoke does not, you know, come into the house and stay over there. So very practically made, and obviously people can decorate it a lot. And in the ancient style, even like in this house, what they've done is they've actually used the initials of the family's name. They actually wanted to have the initials of their family names inside the buildings of their family house. So apart from these small upholstering arches, another salient features were actually the windows. Now these were the windows that are made from wood and oyster seashell. So now these seashells had a dual purpose. So they were translucent, so they made sure that the light actually went in, but the inside was not visible. So it provided privacy as well as illumination. And apart from that, these were not jointed together by a paste in an airtight manner. So it also provided a decent amount of ventilation, which, you know, in a hot and humid weather as Goa, is required. And that's why you'll see most of the houses, most of the old style buildings, they have a lot of windows throughout their walls. They have big windows to make sure that there is great amount of ventilation over there. And this kind of a style still prevails because, I mean, nothing happens to the oyster shells like this. So yeah, that's how they actually like very ingeniously used the natural surroundings at that time to actually come up with very practical utilitarian designs in which they were able to live a very comfortable life. So another salient feature was that the Portuguese never had the grills on the windows over here. So even in Europe, they generally don't have grills. They don't have big iron metal doors. They generally have wooden ones. These were actually added after the Portuguese went away from India. That was in the early 1960s that these grills were installed. Because under the Portuguese rule, the law was that if anybody was caught stealing, their hand would have to be cut. So people did not worry a lot about theft. Yeah. Questionable things, I'm sure, that were happening under those laws, but yeah, because those laws were no longer there, so the residents had to come up with these kind of grill styles to make sure that the ventilation still prevailed, but the safety was also ensured. Another major feature of the Goan interior is actually the tiles. So the hand-painted tiles that we have over here, these are actually handmade tiles on which you have painted it, and then people actually do a zinc coating to prevent it from any kind of major damage or corrosion or decay over time. And people have done amazing amount of artwork over here. People generally use it as nameplates. It has also been used in interiors in many ways. People use good paintings on tiles as well to actually create a very nice depth in their houses. Generally, the colors which are used are a little more ocean related. They are blue, they are yellow, they are green. A lot more naturalistic colors are used over here, which also depict the Goan style. As you can also see, Goa generally has a lot of bright colored houses over here. We have blue, we have red, we have yellow. So all these traditional colors actually came to be from the fact that during the Portuguese rule, only the chapel was supposed to be white. White was supposed to be a color which meant chastity, purity, something which the church had made sure was only meant for their church building and the sacred buildings. Most of the public people, they were supposed to have different vibrant colors to be used to depict their own meaning rather than taking up white as a default. So that is why you'll see all these kinds of colored houses which have been done. Another reason why they were so colored was because they were using natural ingredients and elements to actually make these colors. So a lot of the fruits, leaves, and different pastel colors were used. Yeah, red is terracotta, blue is indigo. Some people say the Asian paints actually adopted a lot of these color palettes into their colors to make the interiors. So another salient feature of the house is the clay tiles which have been used on the rooftop, on one top of the other. So this is actually very common in a lot of other styles also. This is especially where there are heavy rains, heavy snowfall, to make sure that the rain and the snow actually slopes down and they actually come out easily onto the ground, and there are not too many, the roof is not damaged permanently because of gathering of water over there. So that is a very essential part of the Goan architecture, because yeah, we guys have a lot of rain over here, it's a lot of humidity, and one needs to make sure that this is maintained. So the interesting thing is that actually the Portuguese, the people think that the Portuguese came up with the idea of these tiles when they came here and they started with the architecture and construction, but they actually got this idea from the Mexican people, because Mexico was also one of their colonies at that time. So they adopted the idea from there and brought it to India, where it was matured, and a lot of it was used over here consistently because there were so many heavy rains. And this actually design was perfected in Kerala first, and then adopted in India in a very very rapid speed. So these are that is how these tiles were developed, and they became an integral part to the Goan architecture. How they were practical and how they were adopted throughout the ages, you know, from Mexico to Portuguese, then brought it to Kerala in India, and then from Kerala it became famous to a lot of the places, and it became a signature style which was used in houses in Goa.